Welcome back to Kids Fun Science. My name's Ken, and today's experiment is the spinning ball. As always, adult supervision is required. What you need for this experiment is a ball and a glass. What better way of a school lad to start off with a quiz? Can I lift the ball up from the table without touching the ball or tipping over the jar? So I put down a ball, and then I put the jar over it, so I can't tip over the jar, and I can't touch the ball. Can I raise it off the table? So that's the question, to see if we can do that, and I'm sure we can. So we start spinning it. Oh, it's off, but not that long. So we'll try it again and get it going. And there you go. It's off, just like that. Here it is in slow motion. How we did it is we start to spin the glass in small circles very, very quickly until the ball comes off the table and circling around the glass. And once you got that going, you got to continue to keep that speed up to maintain the ball off. And so therefore, you're able to lift the ball off the table without touching the ball or knocking over the glass. So here's the science behind it. As the ball velocity increases inside the glass, the centripetal force increases. That force is what keeps the ball stuck to the side of the walls of the glass. As the ball goes faster, the resulting friction begins to cancel out the force of the gravity acting on the ball. The centripetal force and the friction and those factors rely on velocity. If the ball goes too slowly, the velocity won't increase enough to outdo the force of the gravity, and the ball will fall out of the glass. One thing I found, it depends on what kind of glass you have, is if you're able to do this science experiment. When I use a straight glass like this and go, I'm not able to get the velocity or the centripetal force to catch, and the ball will not stay inside the straight up glass here. But when I use the first glass that you'll see when I put it down here, it's got angled the glass, more like a wine glass kind of, and the ball's able to hold that velocity and the centripetal force. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to click thumbs up and to subscribe. Thanks for watching.